Hi, my name is Jay Forgione, and I'm a senior systems engineer here at Varonis. Today we're going to walk through another type of an attack. At the end of this video, we will break down how Varonis would have caught me in the act. Let's say I'm a bad actor and I was able to compromise an end user's credentials by means of a phishing attack. Very common these days. Let's say her name is Joan, and she works at the front desk, but is now working from home, much like a lot of us these days. Since Joan is working from home and uses VPN, that's how I am going to get in. Fast forward, and we are now in their network. This is Joan's desktop. She's also a local admin, which in most organizations still occurs and is not a best practice. I'm sure someone could also just escalate their privileges easily anyway, even if she wasn't a local admin. What I did was I dropped a batch file, which will trigger on a user logon that calls a nifty PowerShell script. So whoever logs onto this system will see a dialog box which prompts for credentials, so I'm hoping to get someone with higher level creds so I can move laterally and find the good stuff. Since I put the script in, Joan saw the message that looks like an error message to her, so she reached out to the help desk. I was also able to install RSet on here since I have permissions to do so. Let's see what groups Joan is part of before we dig in. She only appears to be in the domain users group. So now I need to get further. How am I going to do that? Well, I'm going to leverage my script to fish for credentials. As I mentioned, Joan already saw the odd message come up, so she submitted a ticket to the help desk. Now I am logging in as IT admin, who is part of the help desk, and let's see what happens. So she mentioned it has something to do with network drives not connecting. Here we go, here's the pop-up. Looks legit, and the Windows dialog box also looks legit, but I am stealing your credentials at the same time and you don't even know it. So he puts his credentials in, sees nothing happen, but now I have his password. Let's check it out. Success. Now, let's move on to the next step, finding the goodies. Before we do, we will need to do a little more recon. Let's do a reverse DNS lookup. You can do this as a regular user, by the way, and don't even require admin permissions, so this will allow me to map out servers in Joan's network so I can figure out where to go next. This will allow me to map out servers in Joan's network so I can figure out where to go next. The script is going to resolve IPs to host names, so as long as the servers are not named like Star Wars planets or characters in Harry Potter, I should be able to find a file server by name. So I have Mr. IT Admin's credentials, so in the meantime, let's see what he has access to. Looks like he can modify GPOs, and oh, he's a domain admin. This is not uncommon in smaller organizations where you have someone in the help desk have domain admin credentials. I've also seen this for sure out there in the wild. Now I could do a lot of damage, but not necessary as I can really go undetected here and do things stealthily and really look for what I want and get it out. So let's see what we have here. Hub filer. Seems like a good start, what do you say? So let's see what I can get to here as Joan. CEO looks like a good target. But as Joan, I don't have access, so most likely the domain admin does. So let's do this. You can first see I'm Joan here. Now I'm going to run the command prompt as an admin and run a tool from Microsoft SysInternals called psexec, which will allow me to run as IT admin. Now you can see I'm the admin. Let's map a drive to that CEO share. So mapping it as IT admin, commands completed successfully. Bingo. Got some good stuff, it looks like. Business plans, new designs, org charts, proposals, lots of goodies. So let's zip this stuff up get it on out of here. We're going to compress it using PowerShell. And once we do so here, the next question is, well, how do I get this out? Well, most organizations, they still allow users to access their personal Gmail. So I'm going to do that. So signing in here to my account, I'm going to send this zip file to myself, and voila. Goodbye goodies. So most likely, no one will even know this happened. How would Varonis have alerted on this attack? Well, from the start, seeing Jones' credentials logging into the VPN from an unusual IP address. Next, we would have seen unusual DNS activity when the reverse lookup kicked off from Jones' desktop. Then we would have alerted on Mr. IT Admin accessing a device he typically doesn't use. And when Mr. IT Admin started accessing the CEO's folder, that would have tripped an alert as well, especially if sensitive data was involved. Lastly, an alert for unusual amount of data uploaded to a website. In this case, Gmail. That would have tripped. And that's how we would have alerted on all that. So if you want more information and see how Varonis can detect these types of attacks, please visit Varonis.com. Thanks for watching.